मॉर्निंग, आज का ऑनलाइन सर्विस में जुड़ने के लिए आप सभी को धन्यवाद। परमेश्वर को धन्यवाद देते हैं, परमेश्वर ने हम सभी को आज का दिन देखने के लिए मौका दिया है। हो सके आपका कल आपका बहुत ही खराब गया होगा, पर आज का दिन आप सभी के लिए बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण दिन है, क्योंकि आज हम लेके आए आपके जीवन को बदलने वाला वचन। आपका बीच में, आपका और परमेश्वर के बीच में जो पर्दा है वो आज हटने वाला है। तो आज का वचन आप ध्यान पूर्वक सुनिए, क्योंकि आपके लिए ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट आज वचन है। वचन में जाने से पहले हम लोग वर्शिप में चलेंगे। हमारे बीच में फ्रांसिस और मार्क है, वो वर्शिप में लीड करेंगे।
क्रिस्ट में मेरे प्यारे भाई और बहनों, आज हमारे इस तरीके से इस दिन का टॉपिक है ब्रेकिंग बैरियर्स, यानी कि बाधाओं पर विजय होना। आज हम सोचेंगे कि हम बाधाओं पर किस तरह विजय हो सकते हैं, बट ये सिर्फ हमारे लिए अकेले से संभव नहीं है। हम बाधाओं पर अपना विजय तभी हो सकते हैं जब हम में प्रभु ईश्वर हमारी मदद करेंगे। और प्रभु ईश्वर से मदद पाने के लिए आइए हम सब हमें इस वर्शिप सेशन में ज्वाइन कीजिए, हमारे साथ प्रभु का आराधना कीजिए और प्रभु से मदद मांगिए कि वो हमें हर बाधाओं से आगे ले सके।
ले चल मुझे तू है जहां, ले चल मुझे तेरे सिंहासन के पास, ले चल मुझे तू है जहां, ले चल मुझे तेरे सिंहासन के पास, ले चल मुझे। मैं तेरे पास आता हूँ पवित्र दिल से, आराधना मैं करता हूँ प्रेमी मन से। मैं तेरे पास आता हूँ पवित्र दिल से, आराधना मैं करता प्रेमी मन से। तुझे ढूंढता हुआ, तुझे चाहता हुआ, मुझे खींच ले मैं दौड़ूंगा। तुझे ढूंढता हुआ, तुझे चाहता हुआ, मुझे खींच ले मैं दौड़ूंगा। तेरे पवित्र स्थान में तू मुझे ले चल, तुझे देखना मैं चाहता हूँ हर घड़ी हर पल। तेरे पवित्र स्थान में तू मुझे ले चल, तुझे देखना मैं चाहता हूँ हर घड़ी हर पल। तुझे ढूंढता हुआ, तुझे चाहता हुआ, मुझे खींच ले मैं दौड़ूंगा। तुझे ढूंढता हुआ, तुझे चाहता हुआ, मुझे खींच ले मैं दौड़ूंगा। जैसे हिलनी पानी के लिए प्यासा मैं भी हूँ ते ढूंढता हुआ मुझे चाहता हुआ छोड़ आया आसमां तू यहाँ भीड़ से मुझको चुना अपना बना लिया नाम तेरा है दिया यीशुआ ले चल मुझे ले चल मुझे तू है जहाँ ले चल मुझे चल मुझे ले चल मुझे तेरे सिंहासन के पास ले चल मुझे
And as we go further in worship, let's remember that we have the victory in Jesus and there's nothing to be afraid of. So let's join in.
I heard an old, old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood's atoning. Then I repented of my sins and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about his healing, of his cleansing powers revealing, how he made the lame to walk again, then caused the blind to see. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal my broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came to me and brought me victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and brought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, then all my love was to him. He plunged me to victory with his redeeming blood.
Good morning guys, and good to see you all once again, and God bless you everyone, those who are joining and those who are watching and joining with us. God bless you all. Today there is a revelation that I want to speak and share with you all. It's a deep mystery that I want to reveal, and this subject is a deep one. I want your careful attention. So before we go, we will pray, and we'll pray for everyone. Lord, we thank you and glorify your name. We commit all the viewers into your hands. Those who are joining with us today, we commit them into your hands. We ask that your spirit might open us, open our hearts, open our spirit, and it may enlighten us that we may see you, we may know you today in a deeper way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So as I said before, today's topic is a mystery that you need to know. It is a revelation that you need to know. We will begin with one verse, and the subject that I will speak on today is the veil or the big curtain. We all know that in the temple there was a big and huge curtain. There was a veil. In the temple there were three places. This veil divided the most holy place from the holy place. We all know that even when Jesus died, this veil, the big curtain, was torn apart in two. So we will see the revelation of the veil, the revelation of veil. Hebrews 10:20 says like this, by a new and living way, which he hath consecrated for us, through the veil, that is to say his flesh. This verse speaks to us that the veil, the dividing curtain in the temple represents the flesh. This big curtain represents the flesh. Now, in the temple, there was a big curtain. Now, this curtain, the length of this curtain was 60 feet. It was 60 feet long. The width was 30 feet. And this curtain was made with 72 pleats or 72 bands, we can say. And in every intertwined plates, there were 24 threads that were used. It is very interesting because in the temple, there were 24 courses of priests. You can read that in 1 Chronicles 24. So this represented the priesthood. When Jesus began his ministry, he was 30 years of age. The width of the curtain was 30 feet. There are some texts that say, when Jesus did his ministry, he sent out at least 72 disciples. And this curtain, it was made of 72 plates, each consisting of 24 threads. The width was 30, but the length was 60. When you read 1 Timothy 5, and also if you see Leviticus 27, this number 60 represents that this priesthood is going to come to an end. 60 was the fulfillment of a person or a thing. It represented that this thing is going to come to an end. So in those days when a priest would tear his garment, it meant that he is forfeiting his priesthood. So when Jesus died on the cross, the garment or the curtain of the temple, it was called as a garment of God. It was torn from top to bottom. Because the Old Testament and the old way of the priesthood was done away with. Because Jesus is our new high priest. So when Jesus' flesh was torn apart, at the same time the veil was torn in two. Because the veil or curtain that divides, it represents the flesh. So the curtain was torn from top to bottom, not from bottom to top, because man cannot reach to God, but God comes down and reaches to man. So the curtain was torn from top to down. In this curtain, there were also three colors that were used. There were three colors used, and these were one of the main colors that I want to speak about. It was the blue one, the purple, and red. Now, in the Bible, every color has a meaning. Blue represents divinity. It is a color of heaven. It is a heavenly color. Purple represents royalty or leadership. And red represents humanity. So Jesus came from heaven, that is blue. But Jesus became man, that is red. So Jesus was both God and both man. So that is why when we take red and blue, we get purple. That is why when Jesus came from heaven, it represented blue. When he was taken to the cross, they made him wear a purple garment. But when he died, he shed his blood. It represents the color scarlet or red. So we see very nicely that this is a picture of the flesh. So there is a reason I'm telling you this, because you need to know something. There is a curtain that needs to be torn apart. There is a curtain that is dividing you and God that needs to be removed today. We know that in the Bible, in the book of Revelation, John has a vision. He has many visitations and he sees the revelation of Jesus. Now this word revelation, in Greek it means the unveiling, or to remove a curtain, or to uncover something. That which is hidden, to reach out to that. So that which is beyond the curtain is exposed. When John was in the island of Patmos, then he had this revelation. What is the meaning of Patmos? Patmos means my death. My death. So when John was in the island of Patmos, that represented his lifestyle, that he is dead to himself in order to live for Christ. So when we are dead to ourselves, then the veil is removed. Then we see the revelation of God. Then we receive the revelation. So the veil represents flesh. This curtain represents the flesh. This thing first we need to understand. 2 Corinthians 3:15 says something. We will see. It says, "But even unto this day, when Moses is read, the veil is upon their heart. The veil is on the Jews. They cannot understand." So, we see that in the temple, there were three areas. If you study the tabernacle, it represents a human body. And if it represents a human body, the first place, the Holy of Holies, represents the head. Or it represents the upper part, the top area. So, in those times, there was the bride, before she would get married, she would always wear a veil on her head. She would always cover her head to show that she is preserved for her husband. She is preserved for somebody else. There is an example in the Bible that Rebecca wears a veil. Even Moses wears a veil. So when the priest would enter inside the veil, it was intimacy with God. He would meet God face to face. Because that area of the tabernacle was the face of God, which was closed. So when a bride gets married to her husband, the veil is removed and she meets her husband, and then they are face to face. So the day when the priest would enter to meet God, the same day was called as face to face. We know this phrase that Moses spoke to God face to face. So if there is a veil between you and God, it is actually covering you from God's face, because face represents the eyes, the mouth, and head also represents the ears. So our flesh comes as a veil in between, that we cannot hear what God is saying. We cannot see the things that God sees, and we cannot understand. Understanding happens with the head. We cannot understand the things of God. So, this veil represents intimacy. That is why the day when the priest went inside beyond the veil to meet God, the day was called as Day of Atonement. Atonement means at-one-ment. It was a time of intimacy. It was a time when the priest could meet God. So, there is coming a time in the end time that the veil on the Jews will be removed. Because they are the bride of God. A time will come when their minds will be enlightened, when they will know that Jesus is the Messiah. So this we need to know. When was the first veil seen in the Bible? If the veil represents flesh, when was this time when this veil was seen in the Bible? The first time we see this veil was when Adam and Eve ate of the fruit that they were not supposed to eat. The first time in the Bible we see the veil of the flesh, or the hindrance coming that divided them between God and man, was when Adam and Eve ate of the fruit. So this veil of the flesh can be removed when we do not eat. What do I mean by that? Before the priest would enter inside the Holy of Holies, he would fast. Without fasting, he could not go inside the veil. Before the veil, there was a table of bread that was kept. That represents fasting. We need to leave the food sometime on the table, and fasting removes the hindrance or this veil, because the veil represents the flesh. Veil represents the flesh. We need to understand this. So, There are many limitations of this veil. The first limitation of this curtain, this big huge curtain, created a hindrance to time. Nobody could enter into the most holy place, but once in a year, they had to wait. And then only the high priest could go. Second, it created a limitation between both the rooms. It created a limitation between the holy place and the most holy place. And thirdly, this curtain, it created a limitation to people. Even the priest could not enter, but only the high priest could enter. So this veil created a limitation to time, matter, and space. So when Jesus' body was torn, he surpassed the limitations of his body. So after resurrection, Jesus was disappearing to appear in another place. Jesus was going through a door and going inside. Jesus went, surpassed these limitations, because limitation is in the flesh. But when the Spirit comes, the Spirit expands you. So the flesh limits you, but the Spirit expands you. The most holy place represented heaven, and the other part of the tabernacle represented earth. So when the priest would go from the holy place back to the outer court, it represented Jesus coming from heaven to earth. What is this division that is in between heaven and earth? What is this division that creates a division between heaven and earth? It is our body. It is our flesh, or the desires and the soul. So what God wants to do, it does not happen in the earth. When God says yes, your flesh says no. When God says no, your flesh says yes. So the greatest hindrance between you and God is the flesh, because you are a spirit and God is a spirit. The thing that comes in middle of intimacy is your flesh. So sometime when God wants to speak to you, you go to sleep, your flesh rests, then God comes and speaks to you. Sometime when we read a Bible, we often think that there are many who understand it well, and we always face problems. We cannot understand it well, because there is a veil, that is the flesh, that oftentimes comes in between us and the Bible. It comes between us and God's word. And that veil must be removed today. That hindrance must be taken out. So in your life, or in your experience, you might be having a veil, a different kind of curtains, or any hindrance or boundary that is coming between you and God. So I believe this word and this message will take out that veil, to take out your veil. It will take out your ignorance behind this hindrances that are there between you and God. So when this veil is removed, or when this flesh is broken, then God's revelation can come in your mind. Because when God speaks to you, and when God's light comes to you, it is a revelatory experience and the light that comes in your mind. But it is our mind, our body, that limits our understanding. So I hope you understand this and remember this. This teaching must go in your heart and your spirit, and your veil must be removed today, so that you might have a deeper intimacy and deeper experience with God. God bless all of you. Father, we pray for all the viewers who are watching. Bless them. May every veil and every hindrance be removed from their life, may be removed from their families. May they experience you and see you in a deeper and in a very strong way. Lord, enlighten their hearts, enlighten their minds. May your spirit of revelation rest upon each one of them, that they may get every answers that they're seeking for, that they may seek you more and more and find you. In Jesus' mighty name, we commit everybody into your hands, and every family member and everyone into your hands. We bless them. May your peace and grace and mercy and your love shine in their lives and shine in every area of their life. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. थैंक यू, गॉड ब्लेस यू, हैव अ नाइस डे।